This is an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar called Ask Larry Anything. Hi, my name is Larry Jordan. In this excerpt, we'll look at how to do a morph cut with green screen footage in Adobe Premiere Pro. Gary asks, I want to use Premiere's morph cut on interview clips I shot on a green screen. But I understand there's a series of steps that are necessary to use morph cut. I believe sequence nesting is involved. Could you please demonstrate how to successfully use the morph cut with green screen footage? And the answer is sure. Here's a chroma key. This is Lisa. It's not a perfect chroma key, but it's close enough. And Lisa does this nice turn to the camera. Let's pretend that this is Lisa talking, because why not? And let's pretend also that I want to do a cut. See that where her hair shifts down? I'm going to do a cut to just take out this section right here. If I take a cut and take out that section, and take out this section, and then get this gone, and pull it over, we have a jump cut. Now you may not see that jump cut on your system because GoToWebinar only transfers about a frame a second, but trust me, it's just ugly. So we want to get rid of that. We're going to go to the effects menu, and we're going to search for the morph cut and drop the morph cut on there. It then has to analyze the clip. While it's analyzing the clip, I'm going to select this right-hand clip, go to up to effects control, and change a setting for ultra key so we can see what's going on, and change it from composite to alpha channel. The alpha channel shows us that which is opaque, white, and that which is transparent, black. There we go. Notice that here I have this left-hand side is the Lisa with the key, and this is the composite, the alpha channel. As I use the arrow keys, you can see how, look at how this is just falling apart. It's not ugly, is the only way I have to describe it. So that won't work. So what we want to do instead, here we go, bring our clips back, is you want to select these clips and right-click on them, nest right here. And we'll just take we'll just use the default name. What I've just done is I've taken those two clips. I've completed the key. The key is inside this sequence. It's a sequence contained inside another sequence. Then I'll take the razor blade tool and cut here and here and delete these two. Delete the two and pull them over. And now select the morph cut and drop the morph cut on there. And again, we're going through the analysis part. What we have inside the nest is the complete and finished key. We then do the edit to take out the pieces that we need to take out to the nested sequence, so the key inside the nest remains untouched. When the analysis is complete, as I use the mouse to move through here, notice how the morph cut is much, it just solved that whole problem. So we don't have the issue of the key tearing out as we move from one shot to the other. So with a morph cut, you create your key, select both the background and the foreground, put it into a nested sequence, select nest, and then do your edits to the nested sequence. This has been an excerpt of a recent Power Up webinar. For the complete version of this online training, please visit my store at LarryJordan.com. By the way, membership is a great value when you need to stretch your training dollars. Membership in our video training library saves you money and time. You can access all our videos for a low monthly price of only $19.99. That's more than 1,900 movies, hundreds of hours on a wide variety of topics. Plus, premium members can download practice media and projects. Our training covers Apple and Adobe software. We update it multiple times each month. And for more information, visit LarryJordan.com/membership. And thanks.